Hey folks, what's up? Jeremy Schaefer here. Well, Easter's coming up, so here's the new model that I just designed. It is a heart that opens up and becomes, ta-da, the Easter bunny. Want to learn how to fold it? Ready, set, here goes. All right, so this is a rather complex model, so I'm going to use a 12-inch square of commie, but you could probably manage to do it from a 10-inch square, but I think it's best to use a bigger square if you can. Okay, so we're starting out by folding it in half. And let's unfold and fold in half in this direction. Make very precise folds. And unfold and let's fold to the crease. And let's turn over right to left and rotate 90 degrees and let's fold this edge to the crease. Rotate 180 degrees and let's fold this edge to here. And now, let's rotate 90 degrees, and let's make a paper airplane fold. So, just fold these flaps right up to the middle line. And unfold them. And now we're going to reverse fold them. So, open here, and let's make this a mountain, and now just push the corner in and close it back up. And let's do the same on the left side. All right, and now let's fold the two flaps up like this. And now let's fold this edge to the crease. And unfold. And now let's fold this edge to the crease. And now fold them both together and make this point stick up. It's a rabbit ear. No, this is not the ear of the rabbit. This is the ear of the horse. No, I'm just kidding. This is the nose of the rabbit. So here we have the rabbit ear. Let's fold it to the right and to the left and back to the right. And let's rotate 90 degrees. And now we're going to fold this corner to right where the crease hits this edge. So right to here. Now let's open the flap up and squash it. Try to make it as even as possible. Okay, let's rotate. And now we're going to fold this flap up. How far? Well, more than that. We're actually going to fold it up about 2.5 millimeters more and just squash right at the right side and the left side. So it's just like that. And now let's fold this flap down about like that. This is going to be the nose of the bunny. Okay, now let's close this flap. Fold it like that, and let's lift this whole flap up right here. And now what we're going to do is hold right here, and we're going to fold these flaps back down, and this should poke back up. Like that. And this makes a curved sort of face, and also, well, you can't really see it, but it makes the rabbit smile a little bit. Okay, let's zoom out. Now let's fold our two flaps up like this and rotate. And now what we're going to do is we're going to fold this flap up between this point and this point, but we're going to go underneath this top layer right here. So just lift it up and make sure that the fold originates right at this corner. You can sort of feel it. Okay, and it also hits this point right here. And just try to make it straight. All right, and now let's turn it over top to bottom, and let's fold right on the crease, and let's rotate 180 degrees, and now we're going to do the same thing on this side. Once again, let's go underneath here, and make sure that it comes right to the corner, and you can just match it with the flap behind. Just like that. Okay, crease sharply. All right, let's rotate 180 degrees. And now we're going to fold this flap up. And we're going to fold it right between this point and we're going to fold it up so that this line, it's actually a crease, it lines up with this edge. You see how that line just goes right to the crease? There, no, right to the crease. And this is going to be the paw of the bunny. Okay, now let's squash it down so that this edge goes right onto this edge. And let's turn it over and let's do the same thing. So we're going to fold this flap up right between here. And we fold it up so that this line lines up. Right. Like that. Okay, let's turn over again. And now we're going to sort of do a petal fold. What we're going to do is fold this up like this, and we're folding this edge onto the crease. So just like that. And now we're going to squash it down. Now if you squashed it right like this so that this line is straight, then that'll make a really big eye. This pleat right here is where the eye is going to be. So let's make it a little bit smaller by making this pleat smaller. So in other words, let's just bend this about, 20 degrees to the right, about like that, and squash it. Okay, let's do the same thing on this side. So let's first make the edge hit the crease, and now just line the ears up so that they touch. And also you want to be looking to make sure that your pleats are the same size. Okay, that's pretty good. All right, now let's make the eye. So what we do is we're just going to reverse fold this flap right here. So just push it in. And if you open it up like this, this should be a right triangle, a 45, 45, 90 right triangle. And now we need to separate these raw layers to open the eye. So let's unfold the reverse fold and refold it and unfold it. And now just reach in and pull the edge down. And now just open up the eye by folding this corner up like that. And there is one eye of the rabbit. And now let's make the other. So let's make our reverse fold. And undo the reverse fold and just fold it like that. And let's open the eye. Just like that. Okay, now let's turn it back over. And now we're going to take this edge and we're going to fold it up like this and squash right there. Once again, it's like this. You just grab it, lift it up, and squash it. So it's like that. Let's do the same thing on this side. So, squash. Okay, now let's fold this flap. Let's fold it up. Okay, I confess I don't really have a guideline for this, but let's fold it a little bit more. Let's fold it about like that. Okay, and turn over, and let's do the same thing. Like that. Okay, now let's just shape the ears to taste. So open up like that, and open up like this. There's one ear, and there's the other. Now we're going to make an interior reverse fold. We're going to fold this flap right through the model to this side, and we're going to fold it right between this point right here and where the chin hits right here. So here we go. Let's open it up, and we're going to make a mountain fold that goes from this point all the way to right here. I'm trying to make it straight. Okay. And do the same thing on this side. So from this point right to where the chin hits the neck. Just like that. And here we have a tail on the rabbit. Alright, so here's your rabbit. You could try to put in a crimp right here. You could even put in a crimp right here, but I think that we are going to skip that because it might tear the paper. So let's just go straight to the pop-up first. So what we're going to do is open right here, and we're just going to make a reverse fold. We're going to just fold this behind like this and close the card. And the rabbit can really go anywhere in the card like this. And you see it just pops up like that. And that's just, you know, that's the about as clean as it's, that's about as clean as it can be as I scrunch the paper here. Okay. So it's like that. And bloop. There it is. And the rabbit is wearing a dress. So you can call it, I don't know, perhaps a rabbit house. Well, if you were a rabbit, you might not be able to make a very straight house either. I don't know how it's the house. okay, but we want to make a heart, so let's undo it like this. And let's open this up right here, and let's squash this down so that the raw edges come together. And let's do the same thing on this side. So open here and squash. So it's like that. All right, well, we're going to kiss this rabbit tail goodbye. Let's just lift this flap up so that this comes out, and let's fold this flap over to this side, and let's do the same thing on this side. So just pull here and fold the flap up. Now let's close the card back up. So let's close it up like this. Okay, so here we have the heart shape. And this is going to be the other side of the heart. So we have to match this side to that side. So let's make a valley fold. Let's fold between this point and the crevice in the heart. Oh, hi, bunny. Try to make it come right to the point. Okay. Okay, and now let's fold this edge up, matching it with the edge behind. Oop, there we go. Really make it come right to the point. So it goes right to the point. Right to the point. Okay. And now let's fold this edge up, matching it to this edge. Okay, and let's fold this up, matching to here. And let's fold this up, matching to there. Okay, all of the creases are sharp. Now let's unfold. And unfold. And now let's reach in. And we're going to sink this point right on this crease. So just basically push it in. It's a closed sink. Oops, let's try that again. It's a closed sink. Okay, and now we're going to reverse fold right here. This is actually a closed sink right here. It might not be on your model, but whatever. Okay. Like that, and next. Okay, for this, let's just fold this inside, a reverse fold. So just fold both layers down. Right on the crease. So it's like that. And then this flap, let's just stick it inside. If you can, you can make it lock right like that. Okay, and there's one side of the heart. Let's do the other side. So you could match it with here, but I think it's best to match it with its real side. So right here and there. Okay, here we go. So fold like this, and I'm just going to fast forward this part. You guys get the idea. All right, so there's the heart, and there's the bunny. All right, now there's one fold that will make the arms just look a little bit nicer. What you do is let's rotate, and let's fold this corner to this corner. Unfold, and reverse fold it right on the creases. And let's rotate. And now we're just going to fold this flap behind. So it's just like that. And let's do the same thing on this side. So let's fold the corner to here and reverse it. And fold this flap behind. Just like that, and you see how the paw comes out a little bit more? Okay, now let's try to put this crimp in here. So what you're going to do is, so this is going to be a valley fold, and right below we're going to make a mountain fold. So it's just like this. And make sure that it goes through all of these layers. Okay, and there's the crimp on this side. Let's turn it over. So once again, this is going to be a valley fold. And let's make the mountain fold right below it. So it's just like this. And there's the crimp. And now let's see if the heart still opens. Yes, it does. So there it is. And there's the Easter bunny. And the heart, and open up. Ta-da! And there's the Easter bunny. All right, well, I hope you're able to make that, and happy Easter, everyone. Bye-bye.